Welcome back, broodlings. Some more Pillars of Eternity. My voice is a little messed up. I'm not sure. Maybe because I just woke up. Anyway, we're done with the dungeon for now. I'm planning on either ending with the dungeon, you know, Paths of Adnua, or with the Radric's Hold. I'm not completely sure, but either way, first we're going to finish up these character quests. These NPC quests of characters we don't have in our party. If I could, you know, I'd have them all, but that would be a little chaotic. Skirmish Archer. I don't remember seeing that one before. Something you want. Alright. I think for the grieving mother, at least, we didn't have to do anything. We just went through conversations last time. So let's see if we can do the same thing. She's off on a thing. Can I? I can't right now. Okay.
Safe travels.
Have Canna stay behind. I really don't want to let any of these people go. So I'm gonna just one person at a time. Now I'm pretty sure. With Sagani, I think I'm just heading to those Adra pillars that are in Elmshore. I believe they're in Elmshore, yeah. Brother. Well, we're gonna send an escort to this supplicant. And it's going to be Firebrand because she's not a player character. No, oh, can I find this Lord Sidrock somewhere in my keep?
Audra Arch, dead ahead.
There you go. This one? The arch, okay. Go to normal speed, so that things are at normal speed. Was this here before? She wasn't with us before, of course. In case you guys didn't know. Oh, whatever he is, we can talk to it. Or him, or her. The Adra Arch looms in front of you, just as you saw it through Persak's eyes. Sagani turns, watching the trees for movement. As the arch's shadow falls over you, the wooded shore fades into a different scene. You're standing in another forest, blackened. Bare trunks claw their way out of the soil and keep a solemn vigil over the young trees and tender shrubs. You move slowly through the woods and the ruins scattered throughout them. Stone pillars and broken arches show the bones of some destroyed building. Between and amidst it all are elves and Orlans, their faces painted and their bows drawn. Burnt trees? Crumbling ruins? Where is this? No one seems to recognize it. I've seen the next location.
I'll follow you.
She counts the arrows in her quiver before adjusting the weight on her shoulders.
I always get a strange feeling near the end of a hunt. Like an itch on the end of my nose.
She hesitates.
I feel like we're close.
Disappointed. No, you sound surprised.
I am. After all this time. A part of me had already accepted that I'd never find him. That I'd be stuck wandering like this forever.
Her hand lingers over a bone-tipped arrow.
I'll admit, I didn't believe you at first. Still didn't until now.
She looks at you out of the corners of her eyes. What changed?
I haven't spent this much time around anyone since the long hunts in Nasitok. But I've gotten to know you, seen how you deal with Kith. Whatever else you turn out to be when we find Theos, you're honest. I know you wouldn't lead me astray in this.
What I mean is, thanks. No one's done this much for me in a very long time. Feels almost like I'm part of a village again. What will you do after this is over?
Good question.
She runs her hand over the smooth, chiseled surface of the arch. After 5 years, I'm not sure what the point of this is. Persak has moved on, and while I'm out here, everyone in Masuk is carrying on as normal. And that'll be the case whether I come back having find Persak or die out here. To be honest, I'm not sure what that means for me. She thumps the Adra wall with the heel of her hand. But I'm getting ahead of myself. First, we've got to find Persak, as well as your quarry, Theodas. Should give me time to figure out what I'll say to him. What do you think you'll tell Persak?
I guess that depends on who he is now. I'd like to think that traveling for 5 years entitles me to give him a solid earful about all of it. But what really matters to someone in Persak's position? The village he left behind? The family he likely won't remember?
If I'd accomplished as much as Persak, I'd want to hear about it.
I hadn't thought of it that way. Who knows? When we find Theos, maybe you'll get your wish.
She adjusts her pack with a quick shrug. Anyway, here's to finding our men soon. See if we can talk about something else. I think we've all... Okay, let's move on. What now? Is... are we supposed to look for the other Edra thing? Okay, so it's supposed to find a forest surrounded by blackened trees and crumbling ruins. The North Weald? I mean, I remember Steaming Falls being rather blackened. And the trouble is, we've been there before, but not with Sagani. Let's head for, I guess, Northweald? Not even sure. I mean, Northweald definitely has ruins, I think. I'm not sure about a blackened forest, but we'll see.
The figurine. It's glowing.
Okay. Figurine's glowing. Any indication on the map? No, I don't suppose so. We'll try looking through different ruins here. This isn't anything, huh? Yeah, you definitely got blackened trees here. Well, I hope she appreciates this. We've barely had her in our party. All blackened would be this side. Looks like we have trees again on that side, so we'll stick to this side of the river and look around. Hopefully if we find another location than this, it'll be easier to figure out. I'll head on this way. Maybe Persak was with these people who were hunting that beast. The whole thing with the, that we figured out for the people in, what do you call it? Twin Elms. You come upon a clearing and see a group of Glamfellen standing in a circle. Sagani glances from the Adra statuette to the hunters, looking for a connection. Meanwhile, the hunters turn and notice you. Their bows are drawn. What are you doing here?
You mock us? Even the keepers of the stone will honor us after this hunt.
They step aside and turn to you, and as they do, you see something on the ground behind them. Lying amidst the ferns is a white stag. Dark blood mars its brilliant coat, and its sides tremble with quick, shallow breaths. You feel a presence in the beast, something ancient and familiar. Before you can speak, something thumps to the ground. You look around and see the Adra bear, its bright glow flickering. Adra bear?
Auric's shadow.
Sagani draws up beside you, her wide eyes fixed on the dying stag. Aloth's face pales. Barath's wheel. Is that? One of the hunters takes a step forward, and Sagani raises her bow, an arrow knocked.
Any closer, and you'll bleed out next to him.
Her voice is low and tremulous.
I never thought I'd prepared myself to meet a stranger. To share the honor and history of my village with someone who had no knowledge of us. Even someone who'd scorn our way of life.
As the hunters back away, she lowers her bow. She watches the great beast's labored breathing for several seconds. Is his soul in this stag? That is low, huh? So you're just going to watch him die?
I was going to tell him about the years of abundance in Masuk. How his granddaughters have hunted caribou, and his grandsons made our walls strong. But he'll be gone in minutes.
Trust your instincts.
He must know that Masuk remembers him.
She takes a deep breath. She kneels by the fallen stag. Placing her hand on its head, she begins speaking. She tells Persak of prosperous decades, of the grain trade that has sustained them through long winters. She recites the stories told about him and speaks of the new elders who have followed in his footsteps. The stag takes a final shuddering breath and falls still.
If you've finished your chanting, we need to get to work before the meat spoils.
As Sagani rises, one of the hunters turns to her and then says that.
Have you no respect? A great soul inhabited this body.
She looks up, horror and anger bright in her eyes. She takes the lustreless Adra figurine.
And it's gone now. What's left is our kill.
How can you show so little regard? Well, of course they have no idea what's going on, right?
Coming from people who revere stones and long-dead Adra.
She draws her hunting knife. Oh, here we go.
She slanders the builders!
Are you so quick to forget all I've done for the Fangs?
Very well. We leave you in peace, then.
The hunter gives you a grudging nod. Quest complete. Grand adventure. I'll assign Sagani once we get back. Yeah, that's it. Okay. Now, I'm not sure. I think if I head towards the nest, we start... I don't know if I can get to the map or if it just goes up there, so I'm just gonna go back down. Radric's undead army will attack the stronghold in 6 days. Or 4 days. Huh. Or almost 5 days. Grand adventure. Firebrand again. We can talk to her again. Oh no, she can level up. That's not the talking symbol. Give her lore. And I don't use her as a character, so... Accurate wounding shot. Ranger's aim becomes deadlier, making his or her wounding shots more accurate. Animal companion gains improved damage. Plus 5 damage reduction to everything. Merciless. Small amounts of sneak attack damage against targets that qualify. Let's make the animal stronger. I can go up again. Swift aim. I gotta read all this, guys. Defensive bond. Binding roots. Well, that's cool. Come back to me and then knock everyone over. I like that. I'm gonna actually use that. Leveled up we have. Okay, let's check this. This one we're not doing. I wonder where this druid is. I don't know why I'm just running in here.
Farewell.
Aye aye. Hiravias. Gonna level up to 11 as well. I really don't know anything about these druids. Wild strike, burn. Okay, so we're adding 30% burn, freeze, corrode, or shock, or bonus spells. Let's burn, baby. We can level up again. Alright, I guess we're gonna go to Twin Elms. And then we gotta come back here to fight Radric's undead army. I'm not sure where this druid is. Ireland payday. Oh, 2 days. How long does it take to get back? Let's see if we can wrap this up quick. I'm not sure what this druid is, guys. Can we do pause? No, not pause. I'm wondering if it might be this lady with the bird. I keep hitting the space bar for some stupid reason. Let's try this. There's not even anyone here anymore. Yeah, why not? Oh, I put it in her regular inventory. I hate that. Hate when I do that. Nope, it's not Lindsay. A rusty key. Oh. What is this? I don't remember where we got the rusty key. And we've never been in there. That's interesting. The hearth still smells of freshly cooked game. Grease spatters the blackened bricks. An Orlin baby lies in the crib, tiny and dark-furred. Though her eyes are closed with sleep, she squirms under the blanket and nuzzles the pillow. Who's this? Quest? What are we doing with the baby? Is this part of Hiravias' quest? What is this? Coco? I'll leave that. Vegetables. Yeah, no idea what this has to do with anything. Should we have taken the baby? Who is this? Lliras' weapon is drawn, and his eyes burn with anger. He looks more like his father than ever. I knew my father was a soulless beast, but you... I don't remember any of this, guys, what this has to do with... He snarls, showing you a row of white but crooked teeth. My father's right about one thing. I can't trust Anestramor's words. I was just going to take her someplace safe. Not a chance, Estramor. Okay, we're fighting them. Who is this? This didn't appear as part of my quest log. Alright, let's start fight. So we'll disintegrate this guy. We're probably in the wrong here, guys. I have no idea, though. Spirit shift into a Stelgar. Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. Stelgar time. As hell. So Hiravias killed him. On to the next. Is Lliras back up? I'm not sure. Palagina. Can he still cast spells like this? Sunlance?
Yeah.
That worked. Well, the area is not going to be very happy with me. If I don't get some answers, I'm going to have to look this up. I don't know who the hell this baby is. I don't remember who Lliras is. And we don't have any quest stuff going on. I don't know. This is the child of Widden, a Glamfellen Anamphath. Though unusually calm and quiet for a baby, this is a healthy infant that has managed to avoid the effects of Widewind's legacy. Okay. The Ethic Knoll. I'm so bad too, I don't remember who the Ethic Knoll are. Alright, well, we're still looking for this druid.
No problem.
Can I find out about this in the... Ethic Knoll. I don't know. I don't know who the Ethic Knoll are. I should know, I'm sure, but I don't. Whoever that is, I'm extremely bad with them. We'll see if they're in Elm's Reach. I don't want to miss this undead invasion thing, though.